Otherwise, Kalista just gets a completely free lane.
Yeah, this dragon's doing so much damage, and EP have to pull off the flash, actually. Being used, carry going to get caught up. They want first blood so bad, and they'll get it. Amazing J gets the reset.
Yeah, so he's able to get in there, pick it up with the Blaze Surge. Now they continue on the dragon. It still does a lot of damage. They need to be careful because there's still three members around.
I mean, it is at 50% health. Raphael's in the area also, so it's 5v4. I guess maybe 4v4 right now with the dragon.
Gank through into the bottom lane, going over that wall.
Yeah, nice little gank actually. Sig set up in the bottom. Kane will get knocked up there as well. Great play by Carry. Nice him into the wall, and Dandy follows up cleanly.
Yeah, and that's a really cool tunnel to use because it gets you out of range of the turret.
They really committed to what was a greedy tower dive in the bottom side, and it set them so far behind. Aurelia's great in a 1v2 situation, and Nav honestly really isn't. So the fact that that matchup's been flipped after the swap is amazing. They're getting so low. Vasili does get the kill, gets stunned at there by Shu as well. The knockup coming in for Drizzle, and Shu will get the trade though.
Yeah, but a support kill for an AD carry kill, I know what I would rather have, and it just continues to deny even more CS.
That's intentional.
As we see Drizzle clearing out a pink ward over this side and in the bottom lane.
Yeah, Fate's Core being popped there as well. Shu will get knocked up there. Vasili moving in, a great hook there by Master. Following play coming through. Tibbers actually could be a bit of a problem there, but Dandy comes in. A great double stun, but Mata collects the kill.
Yes.
And he has with the lead, plus with Mata playing Thresh. He just looks so much better.
Hitong's in so much trouble.
Ulti there coming through there for Azir. Hitong does go down though. Drizzle just ganks him in the face, and Raphael, plenty of burst to help there with the kill.
So there, because Dandy was coming as Dandy's caught out.
Yeah, actually gets stunned up there by Shu. Dandy will tunnel away to the Baron Pit. There's already been ignited. Preyseeker just wide there. Amazing Jake in a duck down there as well. Stun's going to move in. There's the Equilibrium Strike for the slow. Carry moving in. Does get one into the wall. There's Amazing Jake in a move in. Dandy trying to kite away. And Carry not tanky enough yet. Raphael gets the next kill. Mata whiffs the hook there. And now Shu is actually going to get caught out. A great play to start things off. Vasili's here as well. Dandy gets a trade.
Yes, pushing on this turret. Nearly gets it down as we see right now. Hitong responding to that one, but Kang will be able to take it out.
Oh, trouble there as the Santor does move in. Evacu's out of the way. Hitong going to keep chasing in though. The slow comes in, Q's through him, and an easy solo there for Hitong.
Yeah.
Down there as well. Drizzle and Shu actually going to lose the stuns up there. Stun is not going to land. He's actually at a sun turret now, defending there against in EP zone space. Dandy moves in for a knock-up, and that was very well played.
Yeah, a little bit of a bait coming through with that Azir turret, and now they've been completely caught out. Carry's caught Drizzle.
Yeah, Drizzle gets slowed. They're going to force the flash out. Wallop will miss as a result, but Dandy gonna move in there. Kane will dodge back in. Raphael really wants a kill there, does get a bit of burst down, actually chains up the blue buff there as Kane is gonna move in to try and defend it. Soldiers though zoning people out. Raphael diving on the blue. Kane does pick it up, so they will secure their own buff. The flash though forced out by LeBlanc.
Yeah, so all in the meanwhile, with how far behind Amazing J is, he's not using his teleport at all. He's trying to pick up as much farm in this situation as possible. Just wants to be non-interactive. Vici recognizing that.
Amazing J is at least in the area if you're pushing the top side.
Yeah, they also pick up the dragon as well at the same time. So fantastic heads up play coming out of Vici, although they're looking to invade here.
Yeah, Raphael actually going to find Hitong there and gets blown up there, does poor Azir. LeBlanc starting to claim some victims now. Yeah, we see this all the time here. Dandy and Vasili actually going to team up just to make sure if that gets rendered, Dandy will throw it a smite just for fun. There's a little bit more on this game. They're 4,000 gold behind.
Yeah, and he's let that CS advantage creep back towards the 50 mark as well.
Mata gets knocked up there. Shu getting hooked up, and Drizzle just going to dunk him. Dandy, they're diving right into the backline. Mata gets fate called out by Vasili. Dandy almost escapes as Cork. He gets the kill, but Hitong is in the front lines here now as well. Carry almost at Meganar now as well. Vici gonna force EP out, but Dandy did go down.
Yeah, and Raphael might have a little bit of a flank here, so if Carry chases through, they're in a good position.
Shu though, force the flash out. Carry gonna bounce on top of his face there, and Shu has nowhere good to go. Hitong probably gonna clean him out here, but Drizzle actually chasing in. They're trying to save the Annie. They're a good ult there from Carry. Actually killed Shu, but Amazing J gets onto Azir, and Vasili can't find any traction in the fight. Does jump back in, trying to hop around, gets so aggressive, but Kane just destroys him.
Yeah, and that was an amazing fight coming through for Energy Pacemaker. They use of the Cataclysm to shut off the rest of the team as Mata. That is a very brave position to be. On top of a pink ward, yes, but normally people pass through brushes. Single one of your items is around that 3,000 to 4,000 mark. You do a lot of damage.
Yeah, Mata double play actually after landing a good hook there onto Raphael. They will get out though with the gap closes that they have. The scrying goal, we'll see the Mata going so deep actually. Gets Fates Call thrown in there, and he's in the middle of the team, but he's going to get blown up, and Kane just says, thanks, I'll take your gold.
Yeah, exactly right. Amazing J in the meanwhile needs to be careful. He's being collapsed on.
Good stun there coming through, but Vasili's going to chase him down. Amazing J does have a Glacial Shroud. A good Blade Surge in. Might juke them for long enough. The ulti going to come through, but Kane gets Azir, but gets rendered to death. does pull. Amazing J. Now Drizzle diving in the back there with Raphael as well. Keep Vici out. First picture here in this draft is Dandy actually going to catch up through. The knockout comes in and Vasily just cleans him out there. Carry in the Mega Knight form. Going to dissuade anyone else from EP from walking into the brush. The move, and they might try something. Amazing J. It's actually kind of around the side. Going in onto Mata. Kane going to throw a good amount of AoE in, but Mata gets on in. Raphael around the side. Gets knocked back by the ulti, but distorts away. And Drizzle still chasing him, but Kane is getting ripped to pieces. Vasily is going massive here, but goes down to Raphael. Drizzle still locking everybody else up. 2-for-1 in favor of Vici.
Yeah, so Vici managed to pick up the win in that team fight, but they are also low. They need to get out.
The Ren secure there, but Carry and Dandy should get enough. Drizzle wants to steal, but Carry and Mata are going to run interference. Mata actually going to dive in. The fourth dragon does go down. Drizzle gets away, but EP now on a timer and on this fifth dragon.
Yeah, if they get the fifth dragon, they will be... Ooh.
Good pick onto Drizzle there. Knockback there. The flay in there as well. And Drizzle just gets CC'd to high hells. Raphael is going to dive in, try and get the damage there. Mata actually fates calls in and finds Kane. Dandy in a fight with the Umbaru there as well. And Carry going to get the next kill.
Yeah, shutdown coming through. That's a massive pick up there. Being able to get the two, and they actually go for the Baron because it's still 30 seconds on the dragon, and aggressive call coming out.
Yeah, they should have enough time to pick up both here and don't really care if EP get one of the dragons. And at this point, they have to fight Mata. Another great hook there, landing an Amazing J right in the back. Shu getting locked up there as well as Amazing J will actually get the kill onto Mata. Still running in. Raphael has done a lot of work here on the block, just sneaking in there, but Hatong will silence that, and Amazing J runs away.
Yeah, so Raphael able to dodge out here. Oh, will be taken down as well. So that's nearly the clean ace. Only Amazing J lives, and it was for two members, so 4-for-2. But this is an aggressive call. It will be 3v3 when this goes down, and I don't know if they can get it.
Well, Drizzle running in there. He's actually on top of Hatong there. Dandy trying to smite it out. He gets a little too low there. Amazing J dancing in the back. They're going to maybe get the kill into his ear, but a great shield there after the EQ knockout keeps him alive for a little while longer. Kane goes in there. Amazing J still alive, and EP have successfully defended.
So they successfully defend, and they deny the fifth dragon. No Baron fell down, and they actually turned that in their favor. That was a 5-for-4 if you take the extended fight in. What a play out of Amazing J and the jungler Drizzle. Yep. To that bottom lane and start shoving it up with Reckless Abandon, although has been caught by some chains.
Raphael diving in, a little bit of damage, but Carry pretty tanky here right now. It's Drizzle diving very deep onto Mata. There's a good catch that they can go for. Mata double play back. They get Fates called out by Vasily, but Vasily takes so much damage to Raphael, but he's looking very low as well. True moving in, Kane coming in as well. The damage looking good, but Mata still alive there. Kane gets the first kill, finally backs out. Vasily goes down. Amazing J going off in the middle. Dandy goes down as well. 3-0 energy pacemaker.
And Raphael being that low, flashed into assassinate Vasily. What a heads up play, but so brave. If anything went wrong, no margin for error. And that's going to mean the Baron for energy pacemaker, although teleport now coming in.
Carry is actually going to make a job of it. Shu comes look for a stun. He's so tanky is this. Nah, Kane going to dive it. He needs to get to damage, but Hatong's here as well. That's going to force the flash. So Shu could be in trouble. Hatong takes out Drizzle, might get another. Raphael looking so scared right now. Very low on health. Hatong charging in on this as here. Kane going to turn around, a good bit of poke there, and maybe Hatong's like, don't fancy this.
Yeah, there was a very high chance of him being blown up, but the important thing is two members fell very late there, and the dragon has respawned. So unless they can pick up a kill here, which is what Amazing J's recognizing.
Raphael does go down. Unfortunately, Azir gets the kill. Amazing J was trying to set it up, but that might just be it here for EP.
Yeah, could have grabbed the fifth dragon, been in a position to bait a fight around Baron, and used all the extra combat stats. The Baron won't help them around the dragon area. It helps you with pushing, sets up all your minion waves very nicely, but doesn't allow you to do it. And Kane might look to sneak this one away, needs to get a wriggle on.
Good guy Kane does steal it away and just kind of rides out on the earth there as Mata and Dandy are like, where's it gone?
Damage into his kit as, fight starts.
Yeah, actually, Amazing Day almost getting hooked there. I think Mata found another minion, but the Baron Cannon minion is moving in here. Raphael looking aggressive, posturing in, but just trying to poke the minion with just one auto attack.
Yeah, they can't kill that minion. They're too short range, so they're just trying to fire rockets at it, but it's being guarded by Dandy, the human bodyguard.
Yeah, good stuff there. Is Carry actually going to get quite low? Amazing J will get grabbed up there. Raphael wanted to dive in. Can they get the super tank? Vasily diving in, gets a good chunk of damage done to Kane, and Vici break the base.
Yeah, that'll be the inhibitor as well. They got a lot of poke damage through on the other side from Hatong. Vasily going absolutely off now that he's finished up his item build.
Damage on a lot of these carries. And like you mentioned, he's a very volatile fighter. Amazing J going in. Drizzle going to dive in the back as well. Marta trying to defend her, but he gets Fates called out. Amazing J running up from under his turret. And EP are going to shake off the rent stacks and go again.
That's so important. That was only an eek. Wow.
You're actually going to go back in. The Sun Turret moving. Kane gets grabbed there, but a good QSS keeps him safe. Forces the Valk out as well.
Okay, so I was going to say the QSS is in favor of Energy Pacemaker, so that was really important. But a heads up hook coming through from Marta definitely flicks that back in the favor of Ichi. And now the siege starts all over again.
Hatong Sun Turret here, and EP have to defend their Nexus as well. Arise did so much damage to that turret, and it melts.
As well as the teleport, so they feel they have two teleports to one. However, they're just starting up the dragon so quickly.
They have to fight here. There's nothing really that they can do here. Dandy gonna opt into a 50-50 smite, maybe shoot, gets hooked up there. The first dragon does go actually to Hatong and Fiji. Now with fifth dragons are gonna blitz through Energy Pacemaker. Kane getting locked up in the back. Raphael trying to cut him, but Hatong doing so much work in the backside. Raphael gonna get locked up for a bit. Distorts over, but carry will chase him in. Hatong's gonna find him. House hits on the back of the Blunk. Raphael buys a little bit of time with the Zonis, but does go down. Drizzle escapes with his GA intact, but EP will not escape with their base.
Yeah, valiant effort coming through from Energy Pacemaker, but in the end, the Dragons were what won it for VG Gaming. Able to get that one away, and they'll take the Nexus.
And a really crazy game, almost 50 minutes long for VG to wrap that one up. And we have to say, well played to VG. They finally took the game out, but Energy Pacemaker fought so hard.
Yeah.